We're here today with Chuck Salget, who is running for the 16th District for the Oakland County Commission. How are you today?
Good, thank you very much.
Can you tell me what communities are in the 16th District?
The 16th District is primarily comprised in the middle of Troy between 16 and 18, between Dequindre and Adams, with a little bit north of Dequindre and a little bit south of Adams, all of Clawson, and about a 3-square-block section of Royal Oak, about 54,000 people approximately.
Now, why have you decided to run?
I've done this before. I think this is a very critical year for the county, the state, and the country for people to become involved. I think we're in a very highly unusual time for this country, and we've been hearing about getting involved. Now more than ever is the time to make that happen.
So what are some of the issues that are important to you?
I think from a perspective, I think beyond the county, certain things concern me. When I ran in 2016, I talked about it. I think now it's even more important. I think one thing that the county commission and all county commissioners in the state should get together and press to shut down Enbridge Line Number 5 under the Straits of Mackinac, under the Mackinac Bridge. Probably been hearing a lot about that. That line is about 64 years old. If that line was to rupture, 34 to 37 million people would have a tremendously adverse effect on their drinking water. If you think Flint is bad, if that line goes, it'll make Flint look like a pimple on prom night. It's a disaster waiting to happen. I've stated in the past, I don't think Governor Snyder has a clue as to what to do. The Coast Guard has already said they're concerned about their ability to contain it, and that would be in the summer. If that thing broke in the middle of the winter with 6-8 inches of ice, or whatever else in there, we don't have a problem. Wisconsin, Illinois, Indiana, Michigan, Ohio, Pennsylvania, New York, and Ontario could all be adversely affected by a rupture in that line. And the county commissions, I mean, we all want good roads. We want the sheriff's department working well. We have to start going beyond that. That's a critical issue for me. Other things I think we're looking at, protection of our local resources and environments, particularly in our parks, our water. Are there any negative impacts? Every now and then we're hearing something, well, this city had a problem, that city had a problem. Make sure we're solid on that. I also want to see Oakland County get more involved in mass transit. I know that's become a kind of a hot button critical issue. If you take a look at just about every major metropolitan area in the world, the world-class cities, they all have mass transit to serve their population. As we get older, as we get more diverse, mass transit is a critical issue to being able to serve the population. It gets people to and from jobs. It gets people to and from activities. And again, we are one of few major metropolitan areas in the country and the world that do not have a mass transit system. Ironically, metropolitan Detroit before World War II had what was considered to be one of, if not the finest, above-ground mass transit system in the United States. Went away after the war when they got rid of all the trolley cars. Why can't we have something like that again? I know another issue that concerns me, and the commission doesn't directly handle it, but I think we got to start talking about it. We got a problem with guns in this country. I'm not anti-gun. I own guns. I shoot guns. I like guns. But the question is, do we need certain types of weapons? Do we need large-scale magazines? What the county can do on it, I don't know, but maybe we start talking about it and speaking out on it. That would be critical.
Now, what is some of the job experience and political experience that you bring to the table?
I've been very active in the city of Troy. I've lived in Troy now for about 42 years. I've been on the Economic Development Corporation. I was on the Board of Canvassers. I'm a member of the Brownfield Redevelopment Authority. I'm on again, off again as needed on the Troy Historic District Study Commission. I've been a precinct delegate. I've been active in the city. I was a Troy baseball booster coach for a number of years. I was on the board of the Troy baseball boosters. Been a precinct delegate, been active in the community. From a job perspective, I'm a salesman, okay? But I deal with people, and I think that's a very critical thing to be able to do. Of course, just about everybody on the commission deals with people, but I do bring that to the table.
Now, in this race, you do have an opponent in the primary, and
that's
then
correct.
If you win, you will have a Republican opponent in
that's
November.
Correct.
Why should people vote for you?
Because in the Democratic primary, I believe I'm the only true Democrat in the race. I have challenged my opponent. I believe that a convert has the greatest faith. But I don't think my opponent has made the complete conversion, particularly since she's already been supporting one other Republican candidate as recently as the end of March. She's been very active in Republican politics. I don't quite believe her conversion. You want a Democrat, you gotta vote for a Democrat. I'm gonna leave that up to the residents of Troy, Clausen, and part of where I look, decide if they want a Democrat or they want some of the citizens that are Democrat. I can prove it. It's one of these situations, if we both went on trial charged with being Democrats, I'm the only one that would be convicted, so.
Now, if people want to learn more about you and your campaign, where do they go?
They could go to Facebook and look up elect Chuck Salget, County Commissioner. I suppose on there, I'm going to be adding and developing on that, kind of state my positions, what I believe in. I am a New Deal, New Frontier, progressive Democrat. I'm urging all Democrats that are running from local to state to federal to national, the whole gamut. We've got to start finding a message. I believe our message should be very simple. Franklin Roosevelt wrote in 1944 what he called the Second American Bill of Rights, and that's what we as Democrats have to back. Everyone has the right, the opportunity to do a good job at a fair wage, the right to health care, the right to an education, the right to recreation, the time to enjoy it, the right to a decent retirement. All those things are shown in Roosevelt's Second American Bill of Rights. Democrats got to get on that page. How do we compete against our Republican opponents? That's what we are for.
Well, thank you so much for coming out today.
Well, my pleasure. Thank you very much for putting this on.